from your followers to become an effective leader. In order to know what an effective leader is, you would need to know what the keys of effective leadership are. So tonight I will discuss the keys of effective leadership, as well as the different leadership styles, and what some cues are you can gain from your followers to determine which effective leadership style would be best for you. First, I want to start with what makes an effective leader. An effective leader has five qualities. Effective leader is also an effective communicator. They are able to communicate what the goals are, what the tasks are, and what the steps are to achieve the goal. An effective leader also they lead by example. So they don't just work out orders, they also show you what to do, and they do it alongside their followers. An effective leader is very optimistic. They like to look at the bright side of things, and they are ones that find the silver lining in every single battle. Effective leaders also are open-minded. So they are willing to listen to new ideas, they're willing to try new things, and they're willing to go against the status quo, so to speak. And finally, effective leader demonstrates integrity. They do not compromise their beliefs, their morals, or their values just to accomplish a goal. Now that we know what an effective leader is, what are the different leadership types? When doing my questionnaire for preparing for this speech, I discovered that I am actually a coaching leader. And in addition to being a coaching leader, there's also the innovative leader. There is a democratic leader. There's an altruistic leader. There's an affiliative leader. There's a bureaucratic leader, a pace-setting leader, and an autonomic leader. Authoritative leader. With coaching leadership, your focus is on training others how to do the task. And while you train them, you show them what is to be done, and then you watch them do it to be sure that they're doing it effectively. Excuse me, with democratic leadership, your followers are working alongside of you to complete the goal. And with, altruistic leadership, the goal is accomplished with the well-being of your followers in mind. Those are my top three leadership styles. The others, the altruistic, the bureaucratic, and pace-setting, they are more focused on delivering orders. They are not really follower-focused. With those type of leadership styles, they're best in corporate settings where you just set a task and you give it to the team members and then they execute the task. Everything is pretty much laid out already beforehand. So there's no room for creativity or experimentation or anything of that nature. With innovative leadership, however, those goals actually thrive off of new ideas, experimentation, new angles, new ways of trying to solve problems. And some ways that you can determine which leadership style is best for your situation is to listen to your followers. For example, if your followers are very creative, like artists and musicians, and they like to come up with new ideas and they like to experiment a lot, innovative leadership will be best for that because it opens the door for them to try new ways of solving problems. If your followers are in a business type setting and they simply have a project that must be completed, yet they really have no say so to how the project is completed, those are the types where the leader is in control of the steps and the organization of how the goal will be met. If you have followers who are curious about how a goal can be accomplished and want some ideas, want to give feedback, want to be involved, want to be part of something bigger than just setting a goal, and that would be best for coaching leaders. I came from coaching leadership, the way that I use it is by communicating issues with people and then giving them ways or examples of how they can solve the issue, and then they apply it, come back to me, we discuss it, and then we adjust as we go along. So those are different leadership styles that I was able to discover, and there are actually plenty of more of those are the ones that were on the actual questionnaire. And what I recommend is that you take some time to actually learn about the different leadership styles, because even though, as in my case, I'm a coaching leader, I would not always need coaching leadership style depending on the settings. When you listen to your followers, you'll be able to determine which leadership style is best suited for them. That way you can get to the goal